If I want to understand anything like anger or emotions, the first thing I do is I will surf the internet, your videos and books only I surf, and I use those props to understand. I am not sure it is my original knowledge or I am only depending on you.
You can surf the internet, look at the various definitions, look at the scriptures, look at all kinds of wisdom texts to remove yourself. Not to learn something, but to unlearn something. So when you say you search for anger on the net, is it so that you are totally innocent of the word anger? Are you? You already have big stories about the word anger. Now, if you gain further knowledge to cut through your pre-existing knowledge, then it is all right. If there is something that the internet can teach you about anger that helps you puncture your own concepts about anger, then it's wonderful. But do not assume that the internet or books or anybody can really teach you what anger affirmatively is. That you will have to see on your own. And that does not require much doing. Because anger is very close to us and we are very suitably placed to look at anger. Are we not? There is anger. And who am I? The angry one. So who will know anger? Of what use then is all wisdom literature? It helps you remove what you already know. It has a negative function, and that is its utility, that it has a negative function. When I say negative, I do not mean bad. I mean it has a cleansing effect. When I say it has a negative function, I mean it negates, it reduces, it cleanses, it removes. Removes what? That which you are already occupied with.